Hello everybody, it's me, a friendly porcupine, and today we have new Mega Cat Strikes Call of Duty knockoff news! More new photos, and also two brand new figures added on to the jungle set. Yes, if you haven't seen that set, you haven't seen the review, I've also done it, so yeah, you can see the older model and the newer model. Let's start with this. Look here, just look at it. Wow, you get 8 figures. What are the two brand new figures? Well, you get Mr. Hudson over here, and you also get this figure right here. So, yeah, now 8 figures. Unfortunately, they couldn't think beyond the solving annoying boot trick problem. The brand new figures had to have the annoying boot trick. Yep. Knockoffs are just not going to last. Oh well. Anyways, look at this excellent improvement. All of the figures now have glove mode! Yes, knockoffs! That's the way you do it. Good job, every single one. That's an improvement from the previous one. Also, look at this. Do you remember how this ski mask figure used to have no neck? Yeah, it was so hard to articulate. That's the new mold. And on top of that, the new mold is also black color. So now we get a black ski mask, increasing the value, because the black ski mask is the one that is most typically used in most costumes. So I don't have to paint the ski mask black no more. I already have it. That is such an awesome head mold. I love it. Also, what happened to this figure? Why he have no eyes, no eyebrow, nothing painted? Look like a ghost. Ooh, spooky spooky. I don't know why. This guy kinda look off. Anyways, my comrades, do you remember that super awesome cool new Mega Construct Call of Duty knockoff set? Oh boy, that was a mouthful. Well, guess what? Now we actually get to see what they look like. And wow, all of them use the SDU builds. On top of that, all of them have the figure stands. Yes, knockoffs, thank you, thank you. I love it, I love it. They didn't lie about it, even though they didn't advertise the figure stands, which made me a little bit concerned. But they at least included it. Like, good job, knockoffs. Also, here's what the taxidermy doggy looks like. And now the doggy has a hole on the head? What for? So you can attach Halo head molds? Yeah, not exactly sure why that doggy has a hole, but it does, so I guess they improved the mold somehow. Yeah, doggy is still not articulated, which is why it's a taxidermy. What else does it serve? I guess cool paint jobs or whatever, no. Oh, and you remember this mold right here? You can clearly tell based on the photo, based on the image, see? This boot is not fully attached into the other stud. Yeah, there was a problem with specifically this type of boot mold. They usually don't stick super tightly, as to compare the standard this one. Strange, also this one is not stuck so tight. Ay. Yeah. Well, this one's done right, this one's not really. Oh well, moving on, look, the guns are not painted. Just like I said they wouldn't be painted, because knockoffs usually don't paint their weapons like that. So, woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Also, look at that, a black scarf. That is awesome, excellent yellow color. Only the figures have glove hand molds. Even though it's a hand and not a glove. Hopefully they correct this issue, but wow, they've done something right. No more wrinkly arms! Yes, knockoffs, good job. I'm very glad that those stupid dang wrinkly arms are gone. Maybe they've been watching my videos. Maybe they're like, this strange unfriendly porcupine keeps commenting on those wrinkly arms. Maybe we should do something about it. And they did it, and that's what I like. Also, false advertisement. The beard is not painted. But you can always paint that up to you, so yeah. There's also a backpack in the back. Gun, of course, not painted. Annoying boot trick once again. Annoying boot trick over here. The skin tone is a bit off. It's like the hands in the looks a little bit not the correct exact color. I wish it was at least the same color so that way you actually looks like hand. But then again, remember, these are not gloves. I mean they're gloves, but they were supposed to be hand molds and other gloves. So I think it's best we better say that they're just glove molds instead. So yeah, but really cool that they're using this head mold once again. So yay! It's just a much more darker color than what we have previously gotten. So yeah, also rocket launcher, yay! And it's not like how someone new does it with no hole to attach the rocket to. Yeah, X-Block whoops your ass in that department. Moving on over here, we have this figure, which actually looks like it's painted, or is it actually painted? It does kind of look like the legs are painted, but it also kind of looks like they aren't painted. Yeah, it's definitely a different color over here, but yeah, it's like a super, it's like a placebo effect, I think, that's going on over here. It looks painted, but it's not painted. Also, look at this! The riot shield is specifically placed to cover up majority of the figure. Maybe it's to hide that these shoes are not painted. Or maybe they actually are painted. And if they actually are, then why continue this annoying boot trick? But look, Jerrycan, riot shield, excellent. Oh, there's no ghost print on the figure's head. Misleading advertisement strikes once again. But maybe it's for the better. Maybe you really hate those ghost paint applications. Well, now you get this figure without the ghost paint applications and with an excellent gold color visor. So yes, that's excellent. And of course this figure, you get the barbed wire, you get the sandbaggy, done very nice. Hopefully they at least include a set that counts with 500 sandbaggies. I wanna stock up on those. Yes, and the figure stand is used for destruction. Look at this, the care package, yay! And care package number 2. Excellent. And yes, this head mold is essentially the same head mold from that Desert Truck set that I previewed. So, yeah, nothing too special. It just kinda looks a little bit off. The Ghillie Suit Sniper on the other hand looks very tight, so. Good job, Ghillie Suit Sniper. Good job, Mega Constructs Call of Duty knockoffs. X-Block, yeah, it is X-Block. So, good job, X-Block. Also, the Fire Battle Barrel is a pretty cheap trick, but hey, you get the barrel, so that's nice. And you can see, even with this color, there is still that annoying boot trick, but here at least it's not as bad. Oh, do you also remember their super cool SWAT APC? Well, now we actually get to see what it looks like. And yeah, that's what it looks like. Interesting. Look at that. There is a speckle. It's not a super strong speckle, but there is an actual speckle. And look at that. Looks like they also made the little gray brick speckle too. Wow, X-Block! You didn't deliver on a desert truck, but you proved it once again that you can do speckle. So why didn't you do it for the desert color? I don't know. But at least when they do this darker color, they actually deliver on the speckle. So good job, X-Blocks. I'm just not a fan of that hood. That hood right there, ugh. Moving on, they did the side compartment where the thing opens up pretty well, looks aesthetically pretty nice. They didn't mess this part over there where you can attach that jerrycan, also a black jerrycan, very nice. And these mirrors are not painted, not that big of a deal, so yeah. Moving on, you can kinda see it from the back over here, it looks pretty nice. Little windows, yeah, pretty nice, overall it's a pretty good build. Also, I really like these pieces that they use, they're very excellent pieces. Oh, and do you remember this super cool 4-door hammer set? Well, here it is, the SWAT hammer, with actual prints and speckled bricks. Good job, X-Block, good job, like legit, good job. Good job knocking off this truck. Yeah, the doors look like they're done pretty excellently well, the mold with the front window done pretty well. Overall, everything looks like it's done pretty well. I'm just glad they didn't lie about the prints, and they didn't lie about the speckled color. And it looks like this figure right here is having an excellent time holding the weapon. Which looks interesting. Kind of reminds me of something from Ratchet and Clank for some reason. I don't know, the barrel looks a little interesting. Well, my comrades, I hope you've enjoyed this, huh? 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 Why you use a Lego head mold over here, huh? Why you use this piece of crap block over there? That's not what was your source material. Oh, look, the figure, he's crying, his glasses off. My, it must be the middle of July. Oh my goodness, the glasses have melted to his face. That is not a pretty picture. Just imagining glasses melting to your face. That is the things nightmares are made from. Also, no annoying boot trick. Why can't we get back to those days? Also, the prints done very nicely over there. Why couldn't this all just be one consistent color? Beats me. And also, just look at this guy's face. That right there is a meme face. That right there, that's a meme face. So, go ahead, screenshot this thing and make a meme out of it. It's just begging to be a meme. Just the way he looks into your eyes, into your soul. He looks into my eyes, into my soul, because I forgot the most important part of the video. If you like this video, thank you very much, Loco Figure, for reminding me. If you like this video, if you enjoy this video, be sure to give it a like. And as always, my comrades, if you want to see more content from me and Friendly Porcupine, you know what to do. Quadish! And hit the subscribe button, which is Unfriendly Porcupine today, alright, Unfriendly Porcupine. Boom, boom, boom. Hit subscribe and I'll catch you in the next video, my comrades. Take care, everybody. Piece of crap, this also is empty. My goodness, today has been a rough day.